Indeed, God is worth waiting for. His time is always the best. Holy Spirit, good morning for the gifts given to us to watch and wait in the mighty name of Jesus during this season and also the beginning of this year. Amen. Beloved, in Isaiah 18, it appears that the whole world is set to battle God's people. Yet, what is the response of the Almighty God? I'll take my rest and I'll look from my dwelling place. Isaiah 18, verse 4. His stillness may appear to have been an acceptance of the conspiracy against them, but it wasn't. God's response was his reminder that he acts in his timing at just the right time according to his will. I think of Jesus waiting 4 days while Lazarus lay in the grave, John 11:39. Was he unaware? Did he not care? Of course he cared. He was waiting for the right time to act and to teach the lessons he wanted to teach. The Bible records God's delays, many of which seem at the time to be inexplicable from the point of view. Yet, every delay flows from the depth of his wisdom and love, if nothing else. Delay, if we accept it, can produce the quieter virtues, humility, patience, endurance, and persistence, qualities that are often the last to be learned. Are you in distress? Does the Lord seem distant and detached? He is not indifferent to your plight, nor is he unmoved by your pleas. He is waiting while his purposes are achieved. Then at the right moment, he will intercede. God is never in a hurry, but he's always on time. My dear brother, my dear sister, in God's own time, you'll see him work. All you have to do is to stir up your gift and pursue your goal. He will give you hope and lift your soul. My dear brother and my dear sister, waiting is hard. We all know the discipline of waiting. We wait in grocery lines, in traffic, and in doctor's office. We twiddle our thumbs, stifle our yawns, and fret inwardly in frustration. On another level, we wait for a letter that doesn't come, for a prodigal child to return, or for a spouse to change. We wait for a child we can hold in our arms. We wait for our heart's desire. And that is why David says, "I waited patiently for the Lord." As he echoed this in Psalm 40, the original language here suggests that David waited and waited and waited for God to answer his prayer. Yet as he looks back At this time of delay, he praises God as a result. David says, God put a new song, a hymn of praise in his heart. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 3. What a chapter can be written of God delays. Said Abby Mayer, it is the mystery of educating human spirits to the finest tempter of which they are capable. Through the discipline of waiting, we can develop the quality of virtues, submission, humility, patience, joyful endurance, persistence in well-doing, virtues that can take the longest to learn. What do we do when God seems to behold our heart desire? He is able to help us to love and trust Him enough to accept the delay with joy and to see it as an opportunity to develop these virtues and to praise Him. Oh, Thou art the potter. I am the clay. Mold me and make me after Thy will. While I am waiting, yielded and still. My dear brother, my dear sister, waiting for God is never a waste of time. Thank you very much for listening, and may God richly bless you.
Lord, please show me every day as You're teaching me Your way, that You do just what You say.
In Your time.